Hello children, again we are here with a new topic, right? So today we are going to discuss about your topic active and passive voice. So before discussing that, what do you mean by voice? Can you tell me? Okay, you leave about the sound that comes from our vocal tract, that is also voice. But in your English grammar, what is the meaning of voice? Yes, let's see what is a voice. So voice in English grammar is what? In English grammar, voice describes the relationship between the action. Action means what? The verb, okay? And the subject, object, etc. That means what? The doer of the action. Okay? So, voice in English grammar is what? This is a term that describes the relation between the action and the doer of the action. Whether that may be the subject or object. Okay? So, because this is what related to the what, the subject or the object, so this is again of two types. So, voice in your English grammar is of two types. What are that? The first one is the active voice, okay? The first one is your active voice and the second one is your passive voice, okay? So, once again, what do you mean by voice in English grammar? In English grammar, voice means what? It describes the relation between your what? The action and the doer of the action. According to that, the voice is of two types. The first one is the active voice and the second one is your passive voice. So let's see what are these active and passive voice with examples. So, as I said you that the voice is of two types. What are that? The first one is the active voice and the second one is the passive voice, right? So, your first one is what? Active voice. So, active voice means what? The name itself says that something is actively going on. So, active voice means what? Here, in this voice, the subject performs the action. The subject actively performs the action. That type of sentences are called as your what? Active voice. Let's see some examples. So see here, the boy writes a letter. The boy writes a letter. Here, the subject, the boy, is active. Active, that means what? We are giving more importance to the subject here. Yes or no? That means what? The subject is performing the action, we are saying. Okay? So here you can see that the boy is the subject here, writes is the action, and can you tell me the word writes or the verb writes is in which form of the verb? Yes, this is in the basic, that is VS form, right? So a letter is the object here. So here in this sentence, the boy writes a letter, this is in the present tense, and we are saying that this is in the active voice. Why? Because the subject is performing something or performs something. Right? The subject is active. So that's why we are saying that this is an active voice. Something is done by the subject. Moving to next example. Sony cleans the room. Subject is doing something or she has done something. Right? So Sony cleans the room. So here Sony is the subject. Cleans. Cleans means what? This is again the VS form of clean. Right? The room is the object here. Sony cleans the room. This is in the active voice. Why? Because the subject is doing something or it has done something. Okay? Now moving to the passive voice. So passive means what? What is the general meaning of passive? Yes, inactive we can say. That means it accepts what is happening around. So why we are using passive voice? What is the meaning of passive voice is? Here in the passive voice, the subject receives the action. That means the subject is not active, not doing, but it accepts the action. In active voice, the subject does something. But in passive voice, it receives the action. That is the difference between active and passive voice. Okay, let's see some examples. I have given the same sentences as examples so that you can notice the difference between both the voices. Okay, let's see the first one. A letter is written by the boy. What is the difference between the boy writes a letter? A letter is written by the boy. So here a letter is given more importance than the subject, the boy. Who has written the letter? The boy, right? But here we are not giving importance to the subject. That means what? Here directly the boy writes a letter. But here in the passive voice we are saying that a letter is written by the boy. The letter is written by the boy. And always remember that whenever you are writing the sentence in passive voice, the verb should be used along with your be verbs. What are your be verbs? Is, am, are, these all are your be verbs, right? So in the passive voice, the subject, the verb is used along with the be verb. So here you can see that the boy writes a letter, this is in the active voice. When it changes into passive voice, we have used a letter is written. Okay? A letter is written. And the verb writes become written here. Written means what? This is in the which form of the verb? Yes, this is in the past participle form of the verb, that is V3. Write, written. So, is written. So, if the be form is used along with the V3 form, you have to remember that, yes, that is in the passive voice. Is written, is eaten, okay, is cleaned. If the verb is in the V3 form and along with the be verb it is used, then this is in the passive voice. Now moving to the another example, see here. Sony cleans the room. This is in the active voice. Here, the room is cleaned by Sony. Okay? So here the subject is more important. Subject cleans the room. Sony cleans the room. But here what? The subject receives the action. That means what? The room is cleaned by. Okay. The room is cleaned by Sony. Here the subject Sony receives the action. That is the difference between active and passive voice. Hope you understood about this one. So always you remember that active means what? Yes, active means what? The subject performs the action. But passive means what? The subject receives the action. Examples are, the boy writes a letter, or I am eating. I am eating rice. So when we are changing this into passive voice, the rice is eaten by me. The rice is eaten by me. So is eaten. Okay. Is means what? Any of the be verb. According to the sentence we have to use. Again, according to the present tense, past tense and future tense, the forms will change. Okay? So here, hope you understood about this one. So in detail, we will discuss how to change active voice into passive voice and passive voice into active voice in the next video with examples. Okay? In the end of this video, I am adding some more examples of active and passive voice. Please note that in your classroom. Okay?